Hello everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. And in today's video, we are going to discuss a lot of interesting questions. So let's begin today's video. But before that, if you haven't subscribed our channel till now, then you can subscribe and hit the bell notification, guys. And also you can join this Telegram group where you will get the PDF of this session. So the link of this Telegram group is in description below. So here is our first question. Which state has launched the Save Water to Get Free Water scheme? So let me tell you that under this scheme, the state which is the answer of this question has become the first state in India to provide free water to its citizens. So we will be covering that as well, that what are the provisions of this scheme. But let's first know the answer of this question. So the answer is Goa. Now, under this scheme, Save Water to Get Free Water, basically 16,000 liters of water consumption per family in the state of Goa is free. So that is why this has become the first state in India to provide free water to its citizens. Now, apart from this, the Goa government has also decided to put these small businesses and small restaurants into the commercial category. So earlier they were in the industrial category and now they have been moved into the commercial category so that they can also benefit from this scheme. Now guys, related to Goa, you also need to know that it was only the first state in India that became the Har Ghar Jal state in India. So basically in 2020, it provided 100% tap connections in the state under the Jal Jeevan Mission. And by doing that, it became the first state in India to provide 100% tap connections to the rural households. Okay, now apart from Goa, at present Telangana. So Goa, Telangana, Andaman and Nicobar, and you have Puducherry. All of these four, two states, two union territories are Har Ghar Jal states and union territories. So do remember these things. Whereas Goa was the first one, Puducherry is the latest one. Okay, so recently Puducherry has become the UT that has provided 100% water tap connections, and by doing so, it became the Har Ghar Jal union territory. Okay, I hope that this question is clear. Now let's move on to the next question. Recently, Union Minister of Housing and Urban Affairs has launched Pariman, a web geo portal, at the 40th meeting of the National Capital Region Planning Board. Which of the following is the correct objective of the portal? So we have five options: to provide help in the sub-regional and local planning in the NCR. Option B says to help in establishing smoke towers in the NCR region. To provide community Wi-Fi services across the NCR region, to monetize government assets in the NCR region under the national monetization pipeline, to create awareness about the nutrition under Poshan Abhiyan in the NCR region. So which one is the right objective of the Pariman portal that was recently launched by Union Minister of Housing and Urban Affairs, Hardeep Singh Puri? So the right answer here is option A. So this Pariman portal will help this National Capital Region Planning Board in planning in their planning the urban area in the sub-regional and local levels. Okay. Now let us look at the minutes of this meeting. Basically, not the minutes, but the highlights of this 40th meeting. So during this meeting, the minister also launched this agreement, which was signed by Haryana, Rajasthan, Delhi and UP, because these are the adjacent states of the national capital, Delhi. Okay, so Haryana, Rajasthan, UP and Delhi, all of these four have signed this combined reciprocal common transport agreement. And what is the purpose of this agreement? The purpose is to facilitate seamless, that means hassle-free movement of passenger vehicles across the NCR region. Okay. Now this point is not very important. Delhi Regional Plan 2041 was also discussed by the board. Not at all important. Now guys, there will be a single point taxation for all kinds of motor cabs, taxis, auto rickshaws, stage carriage buses, state transport undertakings of NCR, including city bus services. So this was another step that was announced during this meeting. And this portal we have already discussed. Now, what are the things that this portal will cover? The portal will provide details for. So land use, transport, industries, water, power, health, shelter, heritage and tourism, disaster management, etc. So all of these informations will be provided on this platform, which will help this National Capital Region Planning Board in planning at the sub-regional and local level. I hope that this is clear to you. Which of the following has announced snow leopard as its state animal? Jammu and Kashmir, Arunachal Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh, Ladakh, Uttarakhand are in the options, out of which Ladakh is the right answer. So, snow leopards and black necked cranes. So, black necked cranes have been declared as the state bird of Ladakh, and the snow leopard is the state animal of Ladakh. Now, before separation, before the implementation of JNK Reorganization Act, the state animal of Jammu and Kashmir was Kashmiri stag, because this Jammu and Kashmir included Ladakh as well. But right now I am telling you the current state animal and state bird of Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory. So UT of JNK has Kashmiri stag as its state animal, and this black necked crane is the state bird of this UT as well. Okay, so if the question asks you that this black necked crane is the state bird of which of the following state or union territories, and both of the options are given to you, then both would be the correct options. Basically, in that, in your D and E options, you might have options like both A and B or both B and C, all of the above, some kind of options would be there. Okay, so do remember, Kashmiri stag is the Jammu and Kashmir state animal, and black necked crane is the state bird of both of these union territories. Next comes, which country is hosting the ZPAD 2021 exercise? Russia, Tajikistan, Armenia, Mongolia, Kazakhstan. Let me tell you that it is a multinational army exercise, not completely army exercise, armed forces exercise. So that was a slip of tongue. So this is a multinational, let me write it down, armed forces exercise. Now, it was hosted by Russia. And all of the countries mentioned in the options have participated in this exercise. A total of 17 countries participated in this ZPAD exercise. So now let us have a look at this exercise, because this is an important exercise. It is an anti-terror exercise. This exercise took place so that the participants of this exercise can increase their cooperation as per the anti-terror activities, against the anti-terror activities. So, Indian Army contingent also participated in this exercise, which is going to take place at this Nizhny place in Russia. So, do remember the exact location of this exercise. Now, 17 countries are going to participate. Participating countries are these, and these are the observer countries. Now, you have to remember that India is a participating country, not the observer country in this exercise. Now, ZPAD is one of the theater level exercises of Russian armed forces. Now, theater level exercises include Air Force, Army and navies as well. So this is a comprehensive exercise that includes all the armed forces. And a contingent of 200 Indian soldiers were sent to this exercise. Now, this point is also not very important. This was just for your information. The important points are mentioned here. This one, the total number of exercises, the status of India, whether is it a participating country or an observer country in this exercise, theater level exercise it is, and that's all. That is the only points that you have to remember. Who has been appointed as a Secretary General of Rajya Sabha? So recently, Secretary General has been appointed in the Rajya Sabha, and this is the first time in the history of Rajya Sabha that the official who is serving in the Rajya Sabha has been appointed as a Secretary General of Rajya Sabha. Now, before answering this question, I'm going to ask a question from you guys, and that question is, when was Rajya Sabha operationalized? Okay, so which year is the inception year of Rajya Sabha? That you have to tell me in the comment section below. Now, as far as this question is concerned, so option B, Parshuram P.K. Ramacharalu is the right answer. So he has been appointed as the Secretary General of Rajya Sabha. And I'm again repeating myself that he has become the first person or serving official to be appointed as the Secretary General of Rajya Sabha. So do remember this as well. Which company has manufactured the naval anti-drone system for the Indian military forces in partnership with DRDO? So we have the five options: Bharat Forge, Tata Group, Kalyani, Rafael, Advanced Systems, Reliance Naval and Engineering, Bharat Electronics Limited. The right answer is option E. Recently, Indian Navy has signed an agreement with this Bharat Electronics Limited so that the Navy can procure these systems. Now, this system has been developed indigenously. The design of the system is developed by DRDO, whereas the actual manufacturing was done by the Bharat Electronics Limited. Now, guys, this system is basically, this system comes in two modes. So it has two features. One is the soft kill feature, and other one is the hard kill feature. So through this soft kill feature, basically the system targets or the system detects the drones, and through this hard kill system, it shoots the laser beam towards that drone and destroys it in the mid-air. Okay, so that is the purpose of these two features that have been imbibed in this naval anti-drone system that has been developed by DRDO and Bharat Electronics Limited. Now, Bharat Electronics Limited has also stated its intention to sign a similar kind of agreement with Army and Air Force as well to supply these systems to them. But right now, at the present moment, the agreement has already been signed with the Indian Navy. Okay. Moving on to the next question, which country instituted the Raymond Magsaysay Awards 2021? So basically, this is a general question. The Raymond Magsaysay Award has been instituted by which country, or 2021 can also be there. So this is the Asian version of the Nobel Prize. Why is it saying that? Because this prize has many categories. A total of six categories are there. Governance and other categories are there, which we will be looking at. Don't worry about it. But let's first focus on the question itself, that which country has instituted this award. So we have Thailand, Japan, Philippines, New Zealand, and Australia in the options, out of which Philippines is the right answer. Now, the Raymond Magsaysay was the president of Philippines at one point of time, and in order to honor that person, in order to propagate his ideals, this award has been instituted by Philippines. Therefore, the winners of this award get the prize at an official ceremony which is organized in Manila, the capital of Philippines. Okay, so here the official ceremony is organized where the winners of the awards get their actual prize. Now, guys, let's have a look at the categories. So we have discussed all of these. We need to look at the categories of this award. So government service, public service, community leadership, journalism, literature, and creative communication arts. So this is one category. Peace and international understanding and emergent leadership. So these are the six categories under which the Raymond Magsaysay Award is given. Now, you also need to know that since 2009 onwards, the awards are not given in fixed categories. So it is not necessary, like in the Nobel Prize, that every year you will have some winners in each of these categories, in each of the Nobel Prize categories. Here, the awards are not given in each and every category every year. Okay, so that was the fact that you know, don't need to memorize, you just need to know the categories in which this award is given, which country gives this award, and why was this award instituted? Because the other way around that I can ask this question from you is that Raymond Magsaysay was the president of which country? Was once the president of which country? Then you also need to know that he was the president of Philippines. Now these are the winners for the year 2021. So Mohammad Amjad Saqib, he is from Pakistan. Firdausi Qadri, she is from Bangladesh. Stephen Munsi, he is from Southeast Asia. So all of these have got the award for their community services. Okay, you don't need to go into the reasons why these people were given these awards. And if you want to know the reason and it helps you in memorizing the names of these people, then the reasons are mentioned here in the picture itself. You can read it. However, reasons are not very important because they will not be asked from you in the examination. The next award is given to the Watchdog. So this Watchdog is basically a film production unit organization in Indonesia. Next is Roberto Bellin, and he's from Philippines. Okay, he's a fisherman and he is from Philippines. So all of these people have got the award. And here on this note, the session ends. I hope that you have enjoyed the session. Thank you so much for watching it.